go, let's go. Once again, everybody, how y'all doing? So, I have some good news and some bad news to let y'all know is your boy D1, me, personally me, got a song to do, y'all. And the song is about my dad. He used to play it all the time. All the time. Like, that song of his, it's by Lil' Kim. Lil' Kim is one of my dad's favorite songs out through the whole nation. I can't explain it how it goes, but I want y'all to listen to this song. I know a script to write it, but it's a song about me and my dad. We stick together for a long, very period of time. And at that time, we did some stuff as I was growing up. Me and my dad was actually taking trips, like, every day. Let me move y'all over here. Like, every day. I would actually ask my dad for a few things from here and there. Even though he was sick and tired and pain, and it was hurting so bad and I couldn't help him. I would look at my dad like, "Dad, just let the pain go. Just go ahead." And he knew right then and there, I would tell him, let it go. It's okay to let it go. If you in pain, cry about it. You know what I'm saying? Cry about it. So this song is about him. I want to go in tears because it would make me feel bad because I let my dad down on this, even though he's watching me. So I look at it as like, do y'all want to hear this song? Or do y'all want me to, like, don't play it at all? Hit the thumbs up, the bell liking, subscribe to D1. You already know I'm doing it big already. So, this song is about him. All right? Let's get it. Hey guys, here we go. Makes any difference?
I still love you, girl.
You're my weakness. Things in my world. Share my life. Trust in me. You're all I want. You think not me, baby. It makes any difference. Song, y'all.
I give you all my heart. Girl, your sunsets. Wherever you are.
Maybe I'm a dreamer.
You're still my heart.
You're like a little river girl. It's down and out to me. Share my life. Share my girl. You trusting in me. Trust me. You all I want. Hey girl. Everything I need, yeah.
You're my dream.
Just listen to the song, y'all, because y'all don't know what the future is. This is the future for me.
So I sat down one day.
Share my life, baby. Hey, girl.
You can trust in me, girl. Trust,
baby. You're all I want. Baby. Baby.
You're everything I need.
Yeah.
I need you. Hey, girl.
If you want, you want
me, baby. Hey,
you can have it. You can have it,
baby. It's yours. Listen, I want you right here in my world, here in my life, here in my soul.
I want to know
that I need you,
baby.
I receive you.
Yeah, I'm gonna see ya. Shimmer like baby.
Sitting here in my bed, I've been thinking about everything that's been said. I realize what's at stake. From the moment I met you, I just ain't been the same. I need you here in my life, and we both know that's a hard thing to find.
So listen to the song.
Girl, I'm a good man.
My part coming up.
You're a good one. There's so much more I want to discover, baby. It's love, it lasts a lifetime.
In my heart, I know, baby, if it's love, it lasts forever, it'll just stop, oh.
Oh, I pray the faith for the longest time, was in and out of love, oh, I take the path. Tell me, can you comprehend what you make me think? Heaven only knows why broken hearts can't break. I need you here by my side.
My dad, y'all.
If you're not he in the world,
songs. I'm playing it for him. Somebody else.
I'm a good man.
Yes, you is.
And I'm a good woman too. There's so much more to discover with you. If it's love,
if it's love,
oh,
you'll last a lifetime.
Deep
in my heart,
I know.
Love,
if it's
That's a good song. Nobody know about that song. Comment below if y'all know about that song. Who is that by? It's by Lil' Kim. I know because I listened to it. And I miss my dad so much. Nobody can't tell me it's going to be okay. No, it ain't going to be okay. You ain't got no dog. You ain't get no dad that's missing from your life. He ain't die in front of you at the table. He ain't die in your house while you living there with him. He ain't die on the couch. He died on the floor in tears. Letting him know that it's okay to die. It ain't okay to die. You still got a young kid out here just struggling through his lifetime. I got my house taken. Oh, yeah. I got my house taken. But the oldest semblance, they took everything away from me. Everything. And I'm pissed. I'm starting all back over fresh again. So come this week, when my check get here, I'm leaving Flint for good. No matter what nobody says, I'm gone. I'm going to start a new life ahead of beyond anybody's. You hear me? Because life is beyond everybody, and importantly, my dad. And I'm going to go to his graveside to prove y'all that I love my dad more than anybody in the whole life world. Oh, it shows I'm live streaming right now. That's pretty smart. So, remix. Oh, yeah, I can play that song. I'm back, y'all. I'm back once again. You already know it. Best believe it. Your boy D1 never let you down. Never let y'all down. I might have fooled anybody. I don't give a damn. Shit. This is a song called Little Baby. This is a song that actually hit me for so damn long. I couldn't understand it. Just listen to it. I ain't gonna say nothing. Just listen to it.
The main message here is that they want to see those officers involved.
They want to see those officers arrested.
I can't breathe.
Trade my 4x4 for GC3. Ain't no more freeless feet. I get a chance, a chance, a chance again. I even told them please. I find it crazy the police to shoot you and know that you dead, but still tell you to freeze. Fucked up, I seen what I seen. I guess that mean hold them down if you say you can't breathe. It's too many mothers just grieving. They're killing us for no reason. Been going on for too long to get even. Throw us in cages like dogs and hyenas. I went to court and they sent me to prison. My mama was quick when they said I can't leave. First I was drunk and I sobered up quick when I heard all this time and they gave it to Ali. He got a license plus. We just some products of our environment. How the fuck they gon' blame us? You can't fight fire with fire, I know, but at least we can turn off the flames. So every color person ain't dumb, and always not racist. I be judging by the mind and heart. I ain't really in the face. But the way that we living is not getting better. You gotta know how to survive. Crazy, I had to tell all of my loved ones to carry a gun when they going outside. Stay in the mirror whenever you try. Overprotective, go crazy for mine. You gotta pay attention to the sign. Seem like the blind following the blind. Thinking about everything that's going on. I boost security up in my home. I'm with my kind and they right or they wrong. I call them down here, pick up the phone. And it's 5 in the morning, he waking up on it. Tell them wherever I'm at, then they coming. I see blue lights, I get scared as I running. That shit be crazy, they close to protect us. So I've been handcuffed and arrest us. Why they going at night, that shit messed up. Know we need help, they been flagged us. One of them who gon' make them respect us. I can see in your eye that you fed up. Fuck around, got my shot, I won't let up. They know that we a problem together. They know that we can strum anywhere. It's bigger than black and white. It's a problem with the whole way of life. It can't change overnight. But we gotta start somewhere. Might as well go ahead and start here. We done had a hell of a year. I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear. Fuck it, I'm going on the front line. He gon' push your ass if you come past that gun line. You know when it's gon' go away, then the sunshine. Gotta put your head in the game when it's crunch time. I want all my sons to grow up to be monsters. I want all my daughters to show how to plug it. Seem like we losing our country, but we gotta stand up for something. So this what it comes to. Every video I see on my country. I got power now, I gotta say something. Corrupt the police been the problem all up, but I've been lying if I said it was all of them. I ain't do this for the trend, I don't follow them. Altercations with the law, had a lot of them. People speaking for the people, I'm proud of them. Stick together, we can get it up out of them. I can't lie like I don't rap about killing and dope, but I'm telling my youngest to vote. I deal what I did, cause I didn't have no choice and no hope. I was forced to just jump in and go. This bullshit is all that we know, but it's time for a change. Got time to be serious, no time for no game. Ain't taking no more, let us go for them chains. God bless they soul, every one of them names. It's bigger than black and white. It's a problem with the whole way of life. It can't change overnight. But we gotta start somewhere. Might as well go ahead and start here. We done had a hell of a year. I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear. They training officers, the killers, and shooting protesters with these rubber bullets. They regular people, I know that they feel it. These scars too deep, they heal us. What happened to COVID? Nobody remember, it ain't making sense. I'm just here to vent. It happened to one of your people, it's different. We get it, the system is wicked, just learn how to pick it. Knowledge is power, I swear I'm a witness. I know that I'm gifted, I won't go too deep, cause I'm scared they'll get me and scared to admit it. Some shit I can't mention, it's people who can. But here's a chance, I won't take a stand, but I'll take a stand for what I believe. Must not be breathing the air that I breathe. You know that the way that I bleed, you can breathe. I've never been a fan of police, but my neighborhood, no, I try to keep peace, so it's only right that I get in the streets. Much for a reason, I just don't keep peace. How people die for us to be free. Fuck do you mean? This was a dream. Now we got the power that we need to have. They don't want us with it, and that's why they mad. It's bigger than black and white. It's a problem with the whole way of life. Can't change overnight. But we gotta start somewhere. Might as well go ahead and start here. We done had a hell of a year. I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear. It's bigger than black and white. It's a problem with the whole way of life. Can't change overnight. But we gotta start somewhere. Might as well go ahead and start here. We done had a hell of a year. I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear.
Has waited 5 years, 11 months, and 29 days for Adele's newest album. Don't wait another second. Pre-order your copy of Adele's 30 in limited edition crystal clear vinyl today, only at walmart.com.
This is the dimension of imagination.
You know, let's say that's my nigga. I made him a million. The fuck it, we all, bitch. I ain't tryna have babies right now, so we fuck with a rubber, but I got a raw bitch. Know this money bring EV, you probably won't be me, but bro, we can't be around no small shit. Overseas got a crowd doing my shit. Can't believe that I'm still in apartments. Businessman when they got me in office. $1 million deals, I get them often. Me and Dollar was serving on Spawn Street. All legit, he gon' stay with the chopstick. I got raw, that shit made me a monster. He bitch, you know this my sister, my mama's. Now they houses as big as they want them. I didn't run out no motherfucker. Living like we in a race, I might come in first and second, but I won't ever be last. Lately I've been in my bag, but told me don't take my foot off the gas. They give you an inch, gonna take you a mile. I'ma shoot by myself like a 10-5. City to city, got girls going wild, and I reach for my chain when I jump in the crowd. Now I'm also low out of squat.
We finally made it, let's pop us a bottle. I took the lead and let everyone follow. They know I'm running it right to the bank. They want me to ease up, I didn't need with many breathing room. Sorry, I told them I can't. Heard you were ready, so you know what's gonna happen. Whenever we catch you, I run with them straight. Keep all the moves I've been making, by the time I get 40, I gotta be one of them greats. Watch how I move with this paper, I know if I slip up one time, they gon' try to come take. Really, is it getting these niggas be faking? I don't want they vibes, so they hand ain't shaking. She on that 42 scraping, no chaser. I'm trying to get out in here and go taste. Yeah, my diamonds be TV. They don't wanna see us on TV unless it's the news. I got something to prove. Yeah, I'm young, but got something to lose. In the street, I done paid all my dues. No extortion, ain't talking about literally. I be walking on beats, is you hearing me? I just pray that my kids be a big of me. They can't get rid of me. My diamonds be TV. They don't wanna see us on TV unless it's the news. I got something to prove. Yeah, I'm young, but got something to lose. In the street, I done paid all my dues. No extortion, ain't talking about literally. I be walking on beats, is you hearing me? I just pray that my kids be a big of me. They can't get rid of me. Wake up every day, somebody harassing me. I got rich, they need money, they asking me. I was sitting in jail, they look out for me. Once who need me, no same ones who doubted me. I been handling my own, they can vouch for me. They'll wait down with me, know that she proud of me. Turn the heat up, ain't nobody hot as me. Everywhere dollars be, that's how I gotta be. I didn't give her the word, now she not leaving. Said she love me to death, told her stop breathing. He try to do what I do, but we not even. I want all of the beef, I am not vegan. Boy, you said it was smooth, nigga, stop speaking. Vince, the door drop the top, I can't stop speeding. Trying to see if this bitch hit the top speed. Hit a bitch from the back, yeah, but not on me, baby, ho. I control the rock, if the rap slow, I control the block. Yeah, I'm really it, and you niggas not. Got a couple coupe, I can draw the top. I done made it, nigga, all these digits coming in. I'm saving for the bigger picture, no one day I need them. Might as well get used to me, my biggest fear is ending up a used to be. Yeah, yeah, my diamonds be TV. They don't wanna see us on TV unless it's the news. I got something to prove. Yeah, I'm young, but got something to lose. In the street, I done paid all my dues. No extortion, ain't talking about literally. I be walking on beats, is you hearing me? I just pray that my kids be a big of me. They can't get rid of me. My diamonds be TV. They don't wanna see us on TV unless it's the news. I got something to prove. Yeah, I'm young, but got something to lose. In the street, I done paid all my dues. No extortion, ain't talking about literally.
I'm back. Once again, that music is the bomb jiggity bomb John. You heard? I know I got a grown beard. I'm about like
28.
I'm about 28, y'all. About 28, about to grow up into 30s. And I want to inspire somebody up in life. Even though I'm homeless and I'm going through struggles, I know God's on my back every time, trying to point me the right way. I see it. I know it. God, please let my dad come back. Because I need him more than anybody else in the whole damn family. I need him more. He inspired me more than anybody else. Everybody been getting on my nerves. Everybody been telling lies about me. Everybody been getting on me about getting a job. Everybody been getting on me about getting a house. Everybody been getting on me about a lot of stuff. I can't get them things like y'all want me to get. I don't want a house. I don't want no apartment. If I really want an apartment, I would live in my car. Real life, true. I would live in my car more than anything to save my money. More than anything. A car is better than a house. Because I can drive anywhere through Flint without no problems. I can fix my car up, which I'm getting. I'm thinking about getting a car this week, y'all. Thinking about getting me a four-door or two-door. I don't even know. Pontiac Sunfire two-door coupe. I probably think, I don't know what I'm going to get. I think I'm going to get the Sunfire because the Sunfires are easy to work on. And people say, like, none of you ain't. They're hard. No, I worked on them. I know what I'm doing. So, you got engine problems, let your boy D1 know, because I'm the expert at engines. Nobody can't tell me nothing about no engine I don't know about. Hellcats, Hemis, sports cars, Lamborghinis. You can't tell me nothing about cars I don't know about. Engine problems. I know all about them. You take them to the shop. Okay, say if you take a car to a shop, your car, and this car is having so much difficulty. You spending all that money to get it fixed, and you know it's going to have a turnout. Come on, man. Think smart, not stupid. You spending all that $1,000, $2,000, $4,000, $5,000 on a car. You can't even fix your own stuff. You got to go to a shop. You spend all that money for nothing. You wasting money. Save your money up before you have a breakdown. Call D1. I will come right away and fix your car for under $150. Ain't no cheaper way you're going to get it. You heard me? Ain't no cheaper way. So, if you have problems with your electronics, once again, call D1. I'm an expert at everything. I don't need to go to school for nothing. People say, you didn't go to school for this. No, the fuck I don't. when I could learn on my own and make more of a living, more money. I could make more stacks more than anybody in one day. More than anybody in one day. I could make over what? Like last year, I made over $2,000 from helping homeless people out. That was me. I got videos of that. I don't bless them with just a dollar. I bless them with a whole damn 20. I don't give a care if you homeless, broke down, or sad, or something happened to your husband. I don't give a fuck. You only important. Not that nigga. Fuck that nigga. You know, I'm sick of how people come to me, telling me sad stories. My husband beat me. Oh, my husband shot a nigga, or my husband did this. I left Flint alone for a long time. You know what? I stay away from drama. You should too, because they end up in a lockup, or you end up in the graveyard, or you end up dead. You know what I'm saying? All that drama y'all doing, stop it. It's ridiculous. Y'all fucking retarded. See, I walk away. When I did, I'm going to tell you something. I did fucking, 2 years in the county jail, and then did another 30 days in a mental institution hospital. You think I messed up? No, I'm smarter than that. I did my institution 30 days in a hospital up north, Jacksonville Prison, up north. And they say prison are bad. It ain't bad at all. You just got to stay to your limit. You got to stay away from people that have more crimes than you. They got more cases than you. Stay away from that person because that person can lead you up into that crime. And when that person lead you up into that crime, you ain't getting out of prison at all. 2 years, 5 years, don't matter. Stay out of trouble. Do what I do. Walk away from the trouble. I walks away because it ain't my clue in me into that involvement. If somebody arguing with that person, ignore that nigga. For real. Think about it. You in a predicament where your kids is afraid of the daddy. And the daddy has got all this anger in him, built inside of him, that he can't control himself. He start beating the kids. You know what I'm saying? That ain't me. I never laid my hands on any kids in the lifetime. I don't have my own kids. I don't have no kids at all. I'm single, never been married, never had kids, never paid child support. And that's a good thing because I don't want that in my life. Child support is one thing you don't want to do. Have kids. One, have a wife. That bitch is... bitch at you all the time about little ticky-tacky stuff. Oh, husband, can you open this? Bitch, you can open yourself. You got two hands. Oh, act like you handicapped. For real. Think about it. You got a woman in your house. Okay, it's your woman. But she asking you to do things, but you ain't doing it because that's a woman's thing, not a man's thing. Like she say, stay home with your son or spend time with your son. Man, do that. Spend time with your kids. Stop doing all these dumb shit on these streets trying to think you're big and bad, but you ain't. You're just a normal person trying to get into trouble. Think about it. Not think away. Okay, let me say this. Not a way where you end up a divorce. You know what I'm saying? You want to be in a relationship where you want to stick along with your relationship, get along with your wife. Not divorce her. Because if you do, you're going to end up like everybody on the street. Broke, homeless, have no kids. Can't see your kids for a long period of time because you in that predicament where you can't even spend time with your family. That's out of the question. That's stupid. And I'm telling you, the bottom of my heart, I never seen no man in the world spend time with their kids. Oh, it's the COVID. Fuck COVID. You see me living through this COVID thing, I never believed in it. Oh, wear a mask. I don't wear a mask. To the day it started through the COVID, I never wore a mask because I don't believe in that shit. That shit is a crisis to your brain. They when you read the news, I'm going to tell you something. When you read the news, on the news, they telling you lies about Flint, about different areas in Flint. They telling you lies so you can be caught up in that shit. I stay away from that shit because all lies, all white people on the news say, it's the same thing. Oh, we got an earthquake. Oh, this going down. Ain't nothing going down. You just send to be get money out of it. That's acting. They acting. They doing it off a script. when you knowing that you going through some struggles, think in your head the hardest place you ever think. Don't ask nobody, because they're going to tell you a lie. When I know they lying. I lived through Flint. I seen shit that never, ever nobody seen in my lifetime. I seen shit that, I seen stuff that people wouldn't go for, but they all automatically get drunk, get stoned. I see people out in these streets today high as a dog, looking sick, drinking coffee, knowing damn well. They be like, you got a buck to spare? Motherfucker, you don't get off your fat ass and get a damn job. Get your fat ass up to my home. I ran into a boy at the gas station. I said to my, he homeless. I'm homeless too. You don't see me bagging for money. I find other ways to make my hustle. If I have to clean out a house, I go make it and clean out a house in one day and still have like $200 or $300 in my pocket. Because I'm thinking, money come first before any prior. Money come first for anybody. Think smart, not stupid. If you homeless like I am, get off your 2 feet, walk, get a damn job. Tell me you homeless. Tell me you spare. I don't have no money to spare you, nigga. This kid came to me and was like, man, I'm homeless. I'm homeless too. I won't be saying it if I wouldn't. I've been homeless all my life. You think I'm just saying it because I go through the same thing every year, every year. Telling people, get off your feet, get a fucking job, because I have 2 of them, and I can stay home and make my money. Just a minute. People keep calling me on some bullshit. I'm sick and tired of it. Quit calling me. Fucking retards. They calling for no reason. Why they want to call? Ain't nothing important. Quit calling me. For real. I'm getting calls on this cell phone every day. Scammers. Quit fucking calling me. I don't want no interest in none of that shit. I don't believe in it. I don't want any interest in it. People sending me texts saying, pay your taxes. I don't pay taxes, motherfucker. Taxes pay me. Taxes pay me. Quit calling me on some bullshit. If you ain't got nothing to say, don't say nothing at all. Don't even call me. I ain't heard from my brother in so damn long. None of my family, none of my siblings, they won't talk to me. I don't know why they won't talk to me, but they don't want to talk to me. My twin sisters don't even want to spend time with me. My brother don't even want to spend time with me. If I have a day, a whole damn day to think my situation out and figure out who I am, won't you want to spend time with your brother and help him out? Won't you want to do that? No, I have nobody in the family except my mom to help me out on the way. My sisters, my brothers, my aunts, my aunts don't want to talk to me because people out here telling lies about me saying I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I'm right here doing what I got to do. Make my living. Fuck them and fuck who you talk to. You know what I'm saying? I keep it real with everybody. Like, motherfucker, I am not the one to fuck with. I may be skinny and strong, but on the inside, I got the meanest heart ever. If you tell me once, it don't matter if I'm with my family. If you even tell me once, said somebody said something about this or this, I'm going to go off and beat your ass in front of my family. I done so many. I did it to this lady, these 2 ladies. They came in my dad's life, and they was trying to hustle him out of his money. And then they know I'm there. They know they scared of me, too. They scared of me. Wanda, one of them, the bitch, slapped my dad with a cell phone. Right? While he was sick on the couch. I went up to her. I said, I know you didn't, bitch. I will beat your ass. I don't care. You can't hit no woman. Fuck that. If a woman hits you, you got to hit back. Fuck that. I was raised in a white home. I really was raised in a white home. In a white dickerman. People say, why you hanging a lot of white people? Because why I feel comfortable with white, not black. Black is danger. White is comfortable. You know what I'm saying? That's safety. You got to think about it. My culture, okay, black here. Black is here. White's here. I'm with the white. I ain't hanging out with my culture. You know why? Because I'm not trying to end up dead. And I'm not that stupid to follow my actual culture. I'm not being racist. I'm keeping it real. Because my mom don't like white people. Why you talking to white folks? Why not? Don't you want to make friends and not get along with them? No, I don't get along with white people. That's your part. Shit. Like, man, I'm sick and tired of people talking about hang out with your own culture. No, motherfucker. I got what I got. I feel comfortable hanging out with this person. I'm feeling comfortable. Now, older people, like older people, like your parents and stuff, I'm hanging out with because I'm young and I can understand where they're coming from. You know what I'm saying? They see it every day when I go out down the north side. North side love me. The North family loves me. Oh, man. I go over there all night. They love me no matter what's going on. They was like, this young man always walk these streets. Because I'm not messing with these niggas on these streets and getting caught up in some trouble. I'm not that person. I'm not. I wasn't raised that way. I'm not going to be that way. People want me to, you know what I'm saying? They want me to express out my feelings. So when my dad died, I got something to tell. Okay? And it's a serious, and I don't give up. I got to bring it out in the opening. Like, if you got a sister, like a bunch of sisters getting on your fucking nerves saying you doing this and I'm not doing that. I'm on the east side. Where the other white people at? I mean, I'm hanging out with people on the east side where I'm safer at. I was on the east side for like 7 days. I'm still on the east side. Do I care? No, I don't. Because east side, okay, it's dangerous in some way, but people out there in the streets don't mess with me because I don't play them games. I keep it real with everybody. Don't step to me. Don't talk to me if you don't know me. And if you see me on the streets, don't even say nothing to me because I ain't going to say shit to you. It's life. Your family, what you got going on is your life. My life is my life. But if somebody come to me and ask me different things about anything, I'm going to tell them I don't know nothing about it because I'm not really from here. I'm not really from Flint. I'm not originally born in Flint. I was born in Kansas City, Missouri. That was my life. I had a life at a young age. Grew up from a teenager on up. Moved from McKinley, Missouri as 8 years old. On up to now. I've been through so many homes. I've been through so many adoption agencies. I've been through all that. Now I got to get back with my mom and stick along with her. Get along with my mom. When she don't get along with me, when she go behind my back and tell lies, mom, he's autistic or he's this. That's all lies. It's all lies. And I'm sick and tired of hearing it. All lies. Oh, he got this problem. It don't matter what I got. Do I look like I got it? No. Do I look like handicapped? No. Do I look like I need to be in a wheelchair? No. I'm not handicapped at all. And I'm tired of people saying, you handicapped? No, motherfucker, I'm not handicapped. If I can get off my ass and work my ass off, I'm not handicapped. I've been telling that for years, and the people don't listen. Oh, you handicapped? No, the fuck, I'm not. Prove it. Ain't no document saying I'm handicapped, so that otherwise, that's a lie. I'm not handicapped. I can go out and get a job if I want to. But I stay here because if I want to go out there and work in the real world, I can make my money from home online. Why need to just go out in a place and I'm not going to stay right here like I did last year and do the same thing over and over again? Explain to these people. Accept who I am. You know what I'm saying? But if you up in this predicament, you know, and if you going through these struggles, I can't help you. I really can't. Because I'm going through my own problems as a teenager. I don't look like it, but I am. I'm 28, still a teenager. Or adult, but still. In my position, I'm still a teenager. I don't care what nobody says. Oh, you a grown, full grown man. Because I have a beard, don't mean I'm a full grown man. Full grown man means his whole face is hairy. His whole body is hairy. I'm not hairy. I'm just hairy right here. And I can't grow hair on my body at all. Parts of my body, I can't grow hair at all. And people say, why? I was born different. Like my dad keeps saying, I was born different. I was special need different. I don't blend in with my family at all. At all. If I ask my brother, can I come over on the weekends when it's his house? He'll say, no, I got to work. That's an excuse for the book and the Bible. You never have to work and spend time with your family, especially on nighttime. He never spent time with me. None of them. And I'm sick and tired of it. And I kept telling them, ain't nothing important in the nothing important in the world to spend time with your family. Ain't nothing important in the world to spend time with your brother. Hang out, go shopping, do like regular people do. I can't do that because people saying I gotta go to work. You don't got to work. I go to your job and they tell you they don't have to work. That's all excuse. Trying to make up excuses to not come and hang out with your brother. Oh, he gonna bury some me. No, I'm not. I ain't gonna bury your ass. If I bury you, I put you on blast all over YouTube and tell them what you're doing and vlog about it. Like I did last year. And I got over like, what, 1.6K views off one video blogging about different things my family doing. Bro, I'm going to do it again this year. I guarantee you I'm going to do it again this year. Because they're gonna see who they messing with. I'm not the one. So my brother Dominique, his house got broken into. And they stupid enough to live in a trailer. You ain't gonna be safe in no trailer park. Quit acting like you gonna be safe. Oh, nobody gonna bring it here. But you blogging about your life, but you ain't doing nothing for it. You blogging about your life, but you ain't picking up nothing. You ain't teaching yourself, oh, I got to stop showing my house out. Oh, I got to stop telling people I got this. Oh, I got to stop showing my way. Oh, yeah, by the way, FYI, to me and you, my brother is gay. Dominisha, they call Dominisha. His real name is Dominique. He's a boy acting like a girl, which I don't get because I'm the only child that don't do that. Out of everybody in the family, they all react to Dominique. Oh, what up, Dominisha? Oh, what up, Dominisha? Robisha? The fuck? You ain't no damn female. You got a body as a boy. As a man. Why you want to be a female when you're a man? The fuck? That's gay. And I don't roll that way. But I love my brother because we've been through a lot like this. We've been together like this when we was kids. We did a dance when we was kids, and I still remember it. We used to lay down and shake our heads on the pillow all the time till we could fall asleep. Me and Dominique, we would sit there and just roll our... We actually spent time on our birthdays together. If he have a birthday, I go visit him on his birthday. If I have a birthday, he come visit me on my birthday. I don't got no money and all that. My brother full of... I don't got no money. How you gonna buy a car? And okay, so I got another thing to ask y'all. Is it possible if you buy a car the same day you get off of work, you get in a car accident? Ain't no possible way you can get in a car accident and walk out of there. His whole front of his car is smushed with the engine and then was smushed together. The door was all creaking all up. It's all broken all apart. And I kept telling my brother, quit buying these used-ass cars because you're stupid. You don't know what's wrong with them. You just buy it because you see them and you like it. But you got to put all this money into them. And you stupid. If you had me on the side, I would help you out and told you buy a whole brand new car off the lot for under $600 like I've been doing. I bought a Pontiac, a 1998 Pontiac Sunfire. Ooh, boy, clean as a whistle. Ooh-wee. Even though it had a couple things wrong with it. I still bought it and fixed it up and drove it everywhere through winter. I drove it all through Flint in winter. I had a Grand Prix, a Grand Am, I had an Impala. I had all types of cars that people name on the YouTube now. They put on YouTube now. I ain't having customized or detailed and all. I had a car just get me around. But this year, I'm going to have me another car, which I don't know what I'm going to get. I'm just looking on Facebook, Craigslist, online, used car lot sales. That's under $1,000. If I can get that under $1,000, whoo-wee. I just need a van to sleep in. That'd be okay with me. That'd be my home right there. A van on four wheels. I have a vehicle on four wheels. I don't care if it's a station wagon. I drive it. I don't care. Old school is old school. New school is new school. I stick with the old school because I'm old school. And I know about all old school cars. All of them. You can't tell me none about old school cars I don't know nothing about. How to work on them, what year, what a model they came out. I know all of it. I study it. It's what I do. I will actually go on YouTube and study this stuff before I even go out buy me one. See, people don't think when they buy cars, they instantly get in the car wreck, go back the next day and go get a new car. Oh, my insurance paid for it. No, your insurance didn't. You paid in cash. I ain't stupid. Your insurance can't pay for that quick. My insurance paid? No, that's a lie. My lawyer, no, that's a lie. They come up with all excuses to lie to people in public. My husband bought it. No, you, I got you on a video right now. You buying a vehicle. Stop lying. Why people lie? Why they just gotta lie every time? Every time when I mention about a car, they gotta lie about it. They scared that, I bought this because my insurance couldn't pay for it. Be honest with yourself. Did you actually really buy it? Or your insurance covered it? Be honest. Show proof of everything you go through in life. Show proof like I do. I show proof of everything. Like cell phones. These cell phones. I buy them. I got like 36 cell phones in my name. 36. All brand new. Never been dropped. Never been cracked. Never been had a virus on it. None of that. See, this is an iPhone 7 I bought this year. $200. Active. Never been broke. Never been cracked. Worked just fine. See? Y'all see it? Worked just fucking fine. All my phones never been dropped. Never been cracked. Never been through a struggle with falling in water. People say, I dropped my phone in water. That's a lie. You broke it. I have a clip of it. People out here do dumb shit and they know I'm videotaping them. They stupid. Everywhere you go to work, I don't care if you in bed with your husband. I don't care if you at work. I'm investigating your ass, your background and all. You don't have to tell me your name. I already know it by looking at your mail. And what you do every day. See, on the north side, I do that. And I study people. Where they go in the morning. Where they, you know what I'm saying? That's me. I get to know people that way. That's how I do it. I go around, look around Flint. Find anybody that's going through a struggle. Talk to them for a while. Ask them a bunch of questions. You know what I'm saying? See if they're telling the truth or a lie. I know if you're telling the truth or a lie. Because I can look in your eyes and tell that you're going through that problem. And I don't know why people think they can hide that. You can't hide that. I'm going through something. You know, I'm going through a lot. I lost a daddy, two dads, a grandma, and a granddaddy. I know people out here lost a lot of people too, but they don't give a shit. Put him in the ground, bury him. Forget him. They drive around with all these memories of their dad and don't visit their granddaddy or grandma in the graveside. Who does that? Don't do it. Does that? Who don't does that? I do that every day. If I'm out here and I'm thinking about my dad, I'll go out to his graveside and go visit him. Even though he's in the ground with everybody else, I still actually show my respect to my father. Because I'm the only child that does that. Nobody else does. I don't know about y'all, but y'all some fools not to do that. At first, I was scared to go to his funeral when he died. Because I hate looking at a dead body. A dead body, it freaks me out. It really does. It freaks me out. When you see a dead, cold body sitting still, ain't moving, you know that person is dead. I found my dad dead the next morning on the floor, cold. It's a beatdown. I woke up the next morning. I woke up my brother, Kabari. And Kabari was crying and tears. I was like, man, don't tell me he's dead. Don't tell me he passed away. We need him more than anything. We can't handle that house by ourselves. So when he died, I lost everything. My brother left. He went with his brothers somewhere else. He wanted me to come back in Flint to visit me. He wanted me to take me with him. That's how bad life is. Because my sister lied on him saying he was stealing dad's money. He wasn't stealing. I was with him the whole damn day. The whole damn day. How my brother end up at a funeral home. Right, getting bitched out at my sisters and my mom and my brother and all the family. He was stealing the money. How he got his own money? Why you want to steal my own dad's money when y'all was doing it at the same time? Tamara stole my dad's wallet. Angie and Andrea went through paperwork. I ain't going to leave them out. Oh, I'm going to tell it all. I'm going to tell it all. I don't give a fuck. I'm going to tell it all. I'm going to put it on blast. Let everybody know. Don't trust my family. Trust me. You hear me? Trust me. Don't trust my family because they're going to lie to you, turn your back on you, say you did this and you did that. Don't trust them. They all lies, bruh. I'm keeping it real with you for the last time. If I see you out there with my family, hanging out, spending time with them, don't trust them because they up to no good. Tamara up to no good. Engineer Drill up to no good. Dina up to no good. Definitely Dina. She a fast ass, and she go with so many niggas through Flint, can't take care of kids, worrying about other things, can't even take care of house responsibility. She worrying about getting drunk, getting high, doing this, doing that, painting her nails, thinking about herself, not her kids. You know what I'm saying? Who does that? Who kind of mother does that? It ain't my sister, because I don't know her. That's why she don't hang out with me. I asked her to clean out my old house yesterday. You know what she said to me? She said, hell no, I don't need you. It's my house. I can actually turn a cheek on you and tell you, damn, like, actually, I'm this close getting my house back for my sister. I would put a strain order on my whole family. That's in Flint. I would put a strain order. I don't give a fuck. Let them do one more thing to me. I guarantee them I'm a flip it on them. They're going to realize who the fuck they fucking with. And I'm not the one to be fucking with. They already know. Tamara know. Dominisha no, mom no, oh definitely dad no. He already knew right then and there. My son got his back. He don't need no protection. Why you need a gun to fight through a crime? First of all, if somebody got beef with you, fight one by hand. You stupid enough to fight and beef the beef? You stupid. That's how stupid the people are. You want to fight by hand, not by gun. That's how stupid. But I'm gonna get out of here. Subscribe, like, hit the bell. Come on, man. Give me some likes. I know y'all see me on this video. Throw some likes. Let's go. See y'all later.